Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Civil Learning Online, and today in this video I will be discussing about the design of the short column using helical reinforcement. Here I have selected a numerical in which we have to design a short column to carry an axial load of 1000 kN using M20 concrete and Fe415 steel providing helical reinforcement. Whenever we are asked to design, it means we need to find AST, and after finding AST in this question we will find the pitch of the helix. So without wasting time, let's begin the solution and learn how to do the design of this following question. Here the design of the short column is done as per IS code 456-2000, and according to the IS code 456-2000 and as per the provision 39.4, it says that PU, let me show you what is the proof. Here it is clearly mentioned that the strength of the compression member with helical reinforcement satisfying the requirement 39.4.1 shall be taken as 1.05 times the strength of the similar material with lateral ties. Now I am going to show you how to use this statement in the numerical. Here PU is equal to 1000 by 1.05 is the statement which it was saying. Now as the given load was 1000 kN for the safety against torsion and against bending, we need to multiply the given load with the factor safety factor, which is 1.5, so that our column will be safe against bending and torsion. By solving this, we will get the value of PU, and PU will be equal to 1428.57 kN. After finding the PU, we need to do some assumption. So let's see what are the assumptions. In the design of column, we have two formula for finding PU. They are PU is equal to 0.4 FCK into AC plus 0.67 FY into AS, and PU is equal to 0.45 FCK into AC plus 0.75 FY times AS. And this formula is used when our E minimum is greater than 0.05 D, and this formula is used when E minimum is less than or equal to 0.05 D, and when the column is loaded axially. And this formula is used when the column is loaded axially plus bending. And in the given question, we are given just the axial load. It means we will be using this condition, and we have to assume that E minimum is less than or equal to 0.05 D. So let's write it down. Now I have written the formula for PU. Again, we have a assumption as per the clause 26.5.3.1A. It says that our area of longitudinal reinforcement should be greater than 0.8% and should be less than 6% of AG. So due to this reason, we have to assume our AST. Let us assume that our AS is equal to 1% of AG. As you can see that our 1% lies between 0.8 to 6%, means we can take any value between 0.8 to 6% as AS is equal to that much value of AG. So this is going to be 0.01 AG. Now we will replace AG, all the term here by AG, and here we will replace AS by AG, and then we will find the value of AG, and then we find the value of AS. So let's see how this is. Here I have written the value of each and every term, like AC is area of concrete, and area of concrete is equal to gross area minus area of steel, and here it is AS. Now replace AS by AG, what we will have? 1428.57 into 10 to the power 3 is equal to 0.4 into 20 times AG minus AS is equal to 0.01 AG plus 0.67 into 415 times 0.01 AG. Now, after solving this equation, we will get the value of AG. Now, after calculating the value of AG, what we need to do is, this is our gross area, means outermost area of the column, that helical column, circular column, which have helical reinforcement. So from AG, we can find the gross diameter. We have AG is equal to pi by 4 times D square. So on putting the value, we will have 33505 is equal to pi by 4 times D square. So D is equal to, now on solving, we will get the value of D as 412.3 millimeter. This is our minimum, this is the minimum value of D. So let's adopt D in the divisible form by 10. Let's take D is equal to 420 millimeter. Now this is our overall diameter. Now after that, we will draw a rough sketch of the column, and then we will further solve the numerical. Now let's draw our diagram. Here, this is our circular column, and its outer diameter is going to be 420 millimeter, and this is our helix, and this inner portion is called core, and we have got the value of AG. Now we will apply a check, finding 0.05 D, and our D is 420. On multiplying this, we will get 21 millimeter. And our previous assumption was E minimum is less than 0.05 D, and in this case our minimum value of E is 20 millimeter, and we have got that 0.05 D is 21 millimeter. Hence our E minimum is less than 0.05 D, means 20 is less than 21 millimeter, which is true. Hence our assumption was correct. Now our AS is going to be, AS is equal to 0.01 AG. So on multiplying this both, we will get 1335.05 millimeter square. Now let's provide 16 millimeter dia bar, number of bars required is equal to 1335.05 divided by pi by 4 into 16 square. We will get 6.64, which is approximately equal to 7. So therefore AST provided is equal to 7 into pi by 4 into 16 square. This is number of bar, and this is going to be area of one bar. Then the total area provided will be equal to 1407.4 millimeter square. Now as you can see in the clause 39.4.1, we have some conditions which every helical reinforcement should satisfy, which is 0.6 times AG by AC minus 1 times FCK by FY should be equal to volume of helical reinforcement to the volume of core. Now I am going to write this point, and then we will find these value of AG, AC, and volume of helical reinforcement and volume of core. So write, watch this carefully. It is going to be very helpful. Guys, I have written the provision which was mentioned in the clause 39.4.1. And we have already known the value of AG. We need to find the value of AC, B, volume of helical reinforcement, and the volume of core. And for these, for the value of these terms, I need to draw a diagram, rough diagram. So let's draw it. Here, as you can see, guys, this is our overall diameter, which is 420 millimeter. Let's take effective cover 40 millimeter from both side. Let's take 40 millimeter effective cover. Then our diameter of the helix is going to be 420 minus 2 times 40. So write it down. Now after getting the diameter of the helix, diameter of the helix is 340. It means that the diameter from here to up to here, this total is 340 millimeter. Now we need to find the area of helix. So area of helix will be pi by 4 into 340 is d square minus area of this longitudinal reinforcement. And we have the already found the value of AS, which is AS provided is 1407.4. Here AS provided is 1407.4. So we need to subtract this value, which is 1407.4. From here, the value that we get will be the area of helix. So area of helix is denoted by AC. Now we have got the area of AC, and our condition is 0.36 times AG by AC minus 1 time FCK by FY. So find its value, 0.36 times AG, and the gross area is 133505 by AG by AC 89385 minus 1 times FCK by FY means 20 by 415. Now let's provide this diameter of the helical reinforcement was 8 millimeter. It should be mentioned previously before solving this. So its diameter is 8 millimeter. Now after finding its value, we need to find the pitch of the helical reinforcement. Now, as we all know that the diameter, outer diameter of this helix is 340 millimeter, and for the diameter of the center of this reinforcement will be divided by 8 millimeter, means 4 from this side. Center of this reinforcement will be 4 from this side and 4 from this side. Total will be equal to 8. So again, this diameter from center to from this center of the core to the center of this reinforcement will be equal to, we already know that this diameter total is 340, and here the hole is 8 millimeter. On dividing this by 2, 4 from here and 4 from here, so whole diameter from up to the center of the core will be dia up to center of core will be 340 minus 8, which will be equal to 332 millimeter. Now let's move to our next. Now we need to find the volume of helical reinforcement. Then volume of helical reinforcement, you already know that helical reinforcement is provided like a spiral type, means the distance between these two spacing is called pitch. Let us assume that let pitch be S millimeter, and we have to find it for per millimeter length for one millimeter length, and volume is going to be area into length. So area is the area of this helical reinforcement will be given by pi d means circumference of the reinforcement divided by pitch, which is denoted by S, times pi by 4 into d square, and d is the center to center diameter of the helix, which is here d is the diameter of the reinforcement which we have used in the helical reinforcement, and this d is the circumferential diameter, which is pi by S times d was 332, which we had calculated center to center distance, into d is going to be 8 square. On doing this, we will get 5247.3 by S. Now time for the finding the value of BC. You can check here, see here, BC is equal to area of core. BC means volume of core. Volume of core is equal to area of core into length, and the length is already 1. So, and we have calculated the area of core previously. Now here we have got both the value VHS and VC. Now we will equate with these two value with this value as per the condition. So now from here, on solving this, you will get the value of S, which will be equal to 61.5. Now in the provision here for the helical reinforcement provision, page number 49, it is clearly mentioned that the pitch should not be more than 75 millimeter, should not be more than 1/6 of the core diameter of the column, and should not be less than 25 millimeter, and should not be less than 3 times the diameter of the steel bar. So I am going to write it down, and then I will select appropriate pitch of the helical reinforcement, and that will be our final answer. So from these three conditions, we came to know that we can apply pitch S is equal to not more, this is the minimum value, this is 24 is the minimum value, and 56 is going to be the maximum value. So provide S is equal to 55 millimeter, and this is our final answer. And one thing more, I would like to tell you one thing, that the helical reinforcement are provided in those area which are more prone to seismic zones, which are more prone to have earthquake. In such places, it is helical reinforcement is preferred. And thanks for watching this video. If you felt that this video was helpful to you guys, then do like and share this video. And if you want more videos related to civil engineering, then do subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day.